Now, question number 5 is the first question in the grammar section of the paper. Fill any 4 of the following blanks, choosing the most appropriate options from the ones given below. It's an MCQ question. There is a paragraph. Each line carries one blank. Against the blank, you have options given at the bottom itself. You are not supposed to provide the answer by your own. You are supposed to just choose a suitable option. Let's look at the first part of the paragraph. Politeness is said to dash one of the important characteristics of a civilized person. 4 alternatives is be, are, being. What is the sentence looking for? It's looking for a verb. Politeness is said to dash. Which form of the verb should I go for? Said to is, are. They are not in passive form. Be is the only verb that is there in the passive form. And therefore, I can easily say that the correct answer should be option B. And that's what you write in your response. Make sure you write the option number and the answer and not just leave it with the option number. Look at the second part. The dash enemy of politeness is ego. What are we looking for? Adjectives. Less great, more great, greatest, greater. What's the clue? What will help me find the answer? The dash enemy. The article the is only used with superlatives, right? So the most appropriate answer should be option 3, greatest, and that's what we write as the final answer. The third part is to be a polite person, you dash to sacrifice your ego. Again, it's looking for a verb. Which verb can I use with reference to you dash to? To is the clue here. Must cannot be written before to. Have, on the other hand, becomes have to as a modal and therefore should be the most appropriate answer. Thereby, have is the answer to question number C. Now, look at the fourth part. It is difficult dash an egoist to be polite. The missing element is a preposition. It is difficult dash an egoist. Who are we talking about? The person. And therefore, the most appropriate preposition should be for. That becomes my correct answer to the question. Finally, polite actions dash fine results. You are only supposed to write 4 correct answers. Whichever you feel comfortable with, that should be your response. This is the final part of the paragraph. Polite actions dash fine results. I am looking for the correct tense or the correct subject number of the verb. Plural subject carries plural verb and therefore the correct answer should be option 1. Because give is plural, gives on the other hand is singular. Do not be in a hurry to just write it categorically without paying attention to singularity and plurality, thereby successfully completing your answer. Now we look at the next part of the grammar section, which is editing or omission question as prescribed in the paper. Let's deal with that in the next question.